Hello students, welcome to MGC Learning. I am Manju Dilip. Today I am going to start with the 12th standard mathematics topic, applications of derivatives, part 5. We already studied in the previous video about increasing and decreasing function. So today I am going to start with the topic maxima and minima and solving some exercise questions. Maxima and minima. Maximum value of f of x. A function f of x is said to have a maximum value at a point x equal to c if f of x less than f of c for all x not equal to c. The value of f of c is called the maximum value of f of x. At the point c, the corresponding value of c is f of c, that is in the curve f of x. So this is the maximum point. A function f of x will have a maximum at x equal to c if f of x is increasing for x less than c. For all the value which is below c, this function is increasing, and above c it is decreasing. Minimum value of f of x. A function f of x is said to have a minimum value at a point x equal to c if f of x greater than f of c for all x not equal to c. Here f of c is the smallest value. The value of f of c is called the minimum value of f of x. A function f of x will have a minimum at x equal to c if f of x is decreasing, if x less than c, and f of x is increasing for x greater than c, as shown in below. That means here. At x equal to c, if the function is neither increasing nor decreasing, then the function is stationary at x equal to c. The maximum and minimum values of a function are called its extreme values. So, in some questions you can see, instead of maxima and minima, find the extreme values of the given function. That means you have to find maxima and minima. The maxima and minima of a function are not necessarily the greatest and the least values of the function in whole domain. Actually, these are the least and greatest values of the function in a small interval. That is why we have taken delta, c minus delta and c plus delta, that kind of small neighborhood, delta neighborhood. Hence, the maxima or minima defined above are known as local or relative maximum and the local or relative minimum of the function f of x. There are two types of tests to find maxima and minima. So, first one is first derivative test. A function f of x has a maxima at x equal to c if these three conditions you have to apply: f dash c equal to 0, f dash c minus h greater than 0, f dash c plus h less than 0, where h is the small positive integer number. Similarly, a function f of x has a minima at x equal to c if f dash c equal to 0, f dash c minus h less than 0, f dash c plus h greater than 0, where h is a small positive number. There is one more test, that is second derivative test. Here, a function f of x has a maxima at x equal to a if the first step you are doing is you have to find out f dash x, that is f is differentiable at x equal to a. So f dash x you have to find out. Second step you will find f dash x is equal to 0. So you will get two values. So x is equal to a, that value. Here it is f dash a equal to 0. We are substituting x equal to a, that's why. And third step you will find f double dash of x. Then you will substitute this x equal to a here. So f double dash a, if you are substituting f double dash a and you are getting less than 0, then f of a is the maximum value. If it is less than, you will write maximum value of f. To find the maximum value, you will substitute this a in the given function f of x. So instead of f of x, we are writing f of a. A function f of x has minimum at x equal to b if f is differentiable at x equal to b and f dash b equal to 0. So you will get value. So f double dash b greater than 0, then f of b is the minimum value of f. So instead of doing this one, you can simply remember this way. You will find f of x, f dash x first. Second step, you will find f dash x equal to 0. Then you will get two values, x equal to a and x equal to b. Third step, you will find the second derivative of the function, that is f double dash x. In fourth step, you will substitute f double dash a. If it is greater than 0, the function f of x has minimum at x equal to a. To find the minimum value, you will substitute x equal to a in the given function f of x. So f of a, you will get the value. Similarly, if f double dash b, you are substituting the next value. F double dash b is less than 0, it is the minimum value, sorry, maximum value. At that time, you will find the minimum value by substituting x equal to b in the given function, that is f of b, f double dash b. Sorry, f of b. That way you can find out these values. If f double dash b is equal to 0, then second derivative test fails. So you may try first derivative test. You will solve some questions. This is the first question. F of x is equal to 2x cube minus 21x square plus 36x minus 20. You have to find maximum and minimum. So first step is what? You have to find f dash x. Differentiate with respect to x. That is f dash x, that's equal to 6x square minus 21 into 2, that is 42x plus 36. And then 6 you can take, so 6 into x square minus 7x plus 6. 6 you can take out when factorize it. So x minus 6 into x minus 1. Now we are starting the second step. F has maxima or minima if f dash x equal to 0. So this is your second step. We are equating this to 0. So x 6 into x minus 6 into x minus 1 equal to 0, that is x minus 6 into x minus 1 equal to 0. That is, if a b equal to 0, then a equal to 0 or b equal to 0, that we can apply here. X minus 6 equal to 0 or x minus 1 equal to 0. Here, from here you will get x equal to 6 or x equal to 1. So here you are getting two values. This is your second step. Now you will find second derivative f double dash x. So you will find from equation number 1, so 12x minus 42. Now you can substitute 1-1 values of this one to this one. That is your fourth step. So f double dash of 6 is equal to 6 into 2 into 6 minus 7. Substituting and solving, 30 greater than 0. If you are getting greater than 0, you will write the f of x has minimum at x equal to 6. To find the minimum value, you will substitute this 6 in the question f of 6. You will find that is f of x 6 is minus 128. This is your minimum value. Now we are substituting the other value. We have just substituted only this x equal to 6. Now you have to substitute the other value, f double dash 1, and so after solving you are getting minus 30, which is less than 0. Hence f has maximum. If it is less than, you will write maximum. If it is greater than, you will write minimum. So maximum value at x equal to 1. To find the maximum value, you are substituting f of 1, that means x equal to 1 in f of x, that is f of 1 is equal to, this way you will solve it and you are getting minus 3. So the maximum value is minus 3 and minimum value is minus 128. So these steps you have to remember. First you will find f dash x, second you will find f dash x equal to 0, that time you will get two values. Then you will find second derivative of this function f double dash x, then one by one values you will substitute here. If you are getting greater than, you will write minimum at that point. Then you will find that value in f of function, given function, then you will get minimum value of that function. If it is you are getting less than 0, then maximum. To find the maximum value, you can substitute in the function. Next function is f of x is equal to x log x. First derivative is f dash x is equal to x into 1 upon x plus log x, that is equal to 1 plus log x. Now f dash x equal to 0, that is your second step. 1 plus log x equal to 0, therefore log x is equal to minus 1. This can be written as minus log e. Log e value is 1, that is why I am replacing 1 with log e. This can be written as log e raised to minus 1, that is equal to log 1 upon e. So log x is equal to log 1 upon e, equating you are getting x is equal to 1 upon e. Now you will find f double dash x. F double dash x is 1 plus log x is the f dash x, so derivative of this is 1 upon x. Now we will substitute this value in this place. So f double dash of 1 upon e is equal to 1 upon e, that's equal to e, which is greater than 0. Therefore f has minimum at x equal to 1 upon e by second derivative test. To find the minimum value of f, you will substitute this value, f of 1 upon e is equal to, you are substituting in this question, so 1 upon e into log 1 upon e. 1 upon e into log 1 upon e can be written as log 1 minus log e, that's equal to 1 upon e into log 1 value is 0 and log e is 1, that is minus 1 upon e. Therefore the minimum value of f is minus 1 upon e. Next question is f of x is equal to x square plus 16 upon x square. So first derivative of this is f dash x is equal to 2x plus 16 into 1 upon x square, derivative is minus 2 into x raised to minus 3. 2x minus 32 upon x cube. F has maximum or minimum. This is the second step. F dash x is equal to 0. So this is equal to 0. Therefore, 2x cube is equal to 32. X cube is equal to 16. Sorry, x raised to 4 is equal to 16. X square is equal to 4. That is x is equal to plus or minus 2. Now we will find second derivative. F double dash x is 2 minus 32 into minus 3x raised to minus 4, that is 2 plus 96 upon x raised to 4. Now we are substituting one value in this one, f double dash 2 is equal to, and after solving you are getting 88 greater than 0. Since it is greater than 0, f has minima at x equal to 2, and minimum value of f is f of 2 is equal to, we are substituting that 2 in this question, substituting and solving you are getting 8. Similarly, we are substituting the next value, x is equal to minus 2 here, and solving you are getting 8 greater than 0. So both cases we are getting f has minima at x equal to 2 and minimum value is 8. So maxima and minima are not here, here only minimum value is there. Next question is, a wire of length 36 meters is bent in the form of a rectangle. Find its dimensions if the area of the rectangle is maximum. So here a wire of length 36 meters is given and you have to make it a rectangle. Then you have to find the dimensions. Dimensions means length and breadth are the dimensions of the rectangle, and you have to find the dimensions if the area of the rectangle is maximum. So it is given that the area of the rectangle is maximum. Using that you have to find dimension, that is length and breadth of the trapezium. So we are assuming let x, y and a area. Area is also given, that is why capital A be the length, breadth and area respectively of the rectangle. And it is length is given as 36 centimeters. So this is perimeter. Perimeter of the rectangle is 2 into x plus y. So we are substituting this value. So x plus y equal to 18. Therefore y is equal to 18 minus x. That is equation number 1. Now area of the rectangle is length into breadth. That is x into y. That is equal to x into y value. You can substitute from equation number 1. That is 18 minus x. That is equal to 18x minus x square. Now this is your function, a is equal to 18x minus x square is the function for this question. Now you have to find the maximum. So you are starting from here. So first step is derivative of a, that is dA upon dx is equal to 18 minus 2x. So a is maximum if, second, this is your second step, that is dA upon dx is equal to 0, equating to 0, 18 minus 2x is equal to 0, 2x is equal to 18, therefore x is equal to 9 you got. Then you are finding second derivative from this one, that is minus 2, which is less than 0. If it is less than 0, then this function a has maximum when x equal to 9. So from equation number 1, you are substituting y is equal to 18 minus 9, that is equal to 9. So length x is equal to 9 we already got, then now we got breadth is equal to 9. Therefore the area of the rectangle is maximum when the length and breadth is equal to 9 cm. That is the answer for this question. So some exercise questions are given to you, you have to solve it. Thank you.